morning, folks. Back out of Dad's shop. It's the same day as the last video I made. And I've got another lantern. I was gonna put the two together into one video, but there's no real good way to tie the two of them together there. Other than both being lanterns, there's nothing the same about them. So I decided just to record two videos out here today. So I got this thing. It is a Canadian, let's see, it's July of 1934, Canadian lamp base that somebody has put a Canadian Coleman 200A top on. Dad bought it online years ago. It's been on the shelf out here for a long time. We've never tried to light it. And we decided that before I go up to the lantern festival thing that I'm going to here in a week or so, I decided I wanted to see if I could get this thing going. Thought this would be a fun one to take up there. It looks like they've got it set up to burn kerosene. They've got a preheat cup on it. We just have a made in China globe on it. It had an older globe, but it got broken years ago. So we just stuck a made in China globe back on it so that it's got one on there. Yeah, somebody has a preheat cup on it. I don't know for sure if they were trying to burn it on kerosene or if they just did that to make it easier to light in cold weather. I guess I could open up the tank and see if it smells like Coleman fuel, or kerosene, or rotten gasoline. I think I'm just gonna light it on Coleman fuel. The check valve makes noise, so that's not stuck. Let's see what the tank. Tank doesn't smell like anything at all, which is probably good. That generator looks just like a normal 200A generator. Tank's a little crusty inside, but I've seen a lot worse. The bottom has a few little rust spots, but nothing I'm too concerned with. So we'll put some fuel in it and then we'll put a little pressure in it, see if it holds pressure, and see if this thing will work or not. Put a little fuel in and see if this thing will hold pressure. It looks pretty clean on everything, so I don't think I'm even going to pull anything apart. I think I'm just going to put some fuel in it, pump a little pressure in it, put a mantle on it, and see if it'll light. I would not be surprised if it just lights up. That little nut on the top of the cap is free. These caps have a lead seal in them. So you have to actually crank them down pretty tight on here so that they don't leak. Dad's clock is lying. It is not 5 o'clock.
5 o'clock somewhere.
That's what Jimmy Buffett says. Grab a wrench and just snug that down. You can put a rubber gasket in between there, and then you don't have to tighten it near as tight to get it to seal. But I don't have one here right now, and the red seal on the bottom of that looked pretty good. So I think it will probably, without having to be wrenched down too tight, it'll probably hold pressure. Before I put any pressure in, I think I'll go ahead and get the mantle tied on. Then maybe it can break when I'm trying to fumble around and pump pressure in it. All right, I'll pause the camera until I'm done with that. You've all seen me fumble around trying to tie on mantles before. Right. 5 minutes later, I'm done fumbling around. So far, no fuel has leaked out, so it doesn't leak when there's no pressure. There's a couple of rusty spots on the bottom that looked a little questionable, but like I said, I've seen a lot worse and they've not leaked, so. Go ahead. Give this a real quick wipe down just to get some of the shelf dust off of it. Just like the other one, after I take this up to the lantern festival that I'm going to, it will go back on the shelf. So there's no need to get super carried away. I don't know if the camera can pick up where it says Made in Canada on there, but it's kind of neat. It's one of only just a couple of Canadian made lanterns that we've got. Glass doesn't even need cleaned because it's a newer glass. We just stuck back in there. I mean, it's probably been in there for a couple years sitting on the shelf, but it's not sat near as long as all the rest of it to get dirty and crusty looking. Get the porcelain on the top of that.
Yeah.
I'll bet the camera probably can't pick that up real well either, but the porcelain's got like little spiderweb cracks in the porcelain of it. Hopefully they hold together when it starts heating up and don't start chipping and popping some of those little pieces of porcelain out of there. All right, the tip cleaner turns. Like I said, I have not pulled anything apart on this. I don't even know if the fuel knob will turn or not, but it's probably got a little bit of pressure in it just from me moving it around here. So I'm not gonna even try to turn it until I'm ready to light it. I'm gonna trim the strings off my wick, burn that wick, trim the strings off my mantle. You can tell I've been messing with my old Dietz lanterns again. Trim the strings off my mantle and burn that mantle in. Dad just swept this morning, so we'll start a new pile over there for him to clean up. Let's see, lighter's over here. Burn that lighter in. That knob is filthy. Better at least wipe that off a little bit. Burn this mantle in, and we're just going to pump a little pressure in it and see if it'll light. If it won't, then we'll dig into it a little bit farther. But I can't really see anything on this that leads me to believe that it's not going to light right up. Probably means this will be the one that fights me. Check valve rattled, but you know, there was a little bit of pressure in there already and it leaked as soon as I opened it, so I don't know if it's going to actually hold well. So it's leaking out around that check valve. I can crack that back loose and just spray a little WD-40 in there and see if that'll get that check valve to hold. Sometimes just a little shot of WD-40 is all it takes to get check valve to hold. Actually, I don't know if I've... But I can spray a little bit of WD-40 down in there. Rattle it around a little bit. Put it back together and we'll see if it'll hold. Even if it leaks by slowly, it's not the end of the world. You can pump it up and get the valve shut quickly and it'll be fine. I guess if it does leak by, I'll still try this video, but before I take it up to the lantern show, I've got another table lamp at home that's got this same cap. I'll just swap it out for while we're at the show and then put the correct one back on when we get back. We'll try it one more time now. It might. Sometimes a little WD-40 is all it takes. Yeah, it's still leaking, but I've got plenty of pressure in there and it's not leaking at all when you close the seal. So it will be good enough to try it out, see if it's gonna work, and then I can swap that cap out if I take it up to the lantern show. So let's turn that tip cleaner a couple times and then try and light it up, see what it does. Well, it's burning. Not necessarily exactly how I want it to, but... Whoa! Just one more quick side note. I think about it every time I have a lantern flare up the way that that put together Canadian lantern did when I lit it. If you're doing this stuff inside, actually, if you're not comfortable with lanterns and not been around them a lot, I suggest lighting them outdoors. We have lit hundreds of lanterns and are very comfortable doing it. But we also have, within 3 feet of where I'm sitting right here, a large fire extinguisher. Be sure if you're working on this stuff indoors, you have a fire extinguisher close by, because you saw how much that one flared up. I've seen them do way worse before. I've seen them have flames 3 feet tall before. So if you're working on these inside, be very sure that you've got a good fire extinguisher nearby. Calm down. Honestly, if they were burning kerosene in it, it could have still had some kerosene residue inside that generator. It looks to me like just a regular 200A generator. I've got a little bit of fuel leaking right there around the packing on that knob. I'm gonna try to tighten that up before it bursts into flames. Yep, that did it. You usually don't have to turn those packing nuts very far at all. A small turn will seal them right up. It is burning nice and bright like a regular 200A. Put the globe on it. Throw the vent on there. The vent does still have the bale catch in there, but there was no bale on it when we got it. But that's probably just because they were using it as a table lamp instead of a regular lantern. And some people like to do that, and then you could use your table lamp outdoors. where the wind wouldn't blow it out immediately. There we have it. It's burning nice. Kind of a unique little, some people call them a Frankie, like a Frankenstein lantern. Some people call it a lamp turn. I kind of like that, the old lamp turn. So that one is brought back to life, burning nice. It'll work good for the show I'm going to, and then after we come back home, we'll probably go back out on the shelf. We'll burn it until we burn all the fuel out of it, let the fount dry out, and put it back out on the shelf. Thanks everyone for watching. Please hit the subscribe button, leave the video a like, leave a comment, and then come on back next week. We'll have a video of something here for you to watch.